Sidos, Luis Noguera Serrano, President of the European Movement Society. And we are here at Home Dojo today on Sunday in Valencia, Spain. And I have here on my left is Sensei José Tola from Zamora, Vice President of the Spanish Bugay Society and responsible for Spain on the International Bugay Society too. He, as I have explained before, is Sensei, and he is preparing hardly for testing after a few years for Sidos graduation. Then today I am sharing with him and mainly also with Alonso Martin from Madrid, preparing also himself for Sensei graduation. And as I am explaining to them some characteristics about what it's the subonym that we have been sharing some small information in the past day. Today we will continue with some techniques about kogi, that is the dangerous visit, and some other regarding the techniques that the subonym developed in the past centuries to defend a lord against other enemies. And in this case, we will do the following thing. I will explain some details, and after this I will ask Sensei Tola to perform these sequences. Remember that this study links us to the idea to defend a door that is in danger of a hatamoto. Hatamoto is a person that is bringing their weapons to a meeting and has the trust to wear them on this formal meeting or this ceremony, etc. Then we will cover several attacks with the idea to understand basic concepts of this subonym. Please, Jose-san. In the first sequence, we will start on seiza position. After meeting, we need to be on seiza position. I will be at this side. I am the subonym, the protector, and as he knows that I am here to defend the law, the first thing that he will try to do is to attack me. He will perform a double attack, very strong, trying to hit with the both fists and knuckles to my chest in front and the back side. Then, for first thing, please do it. From here, I will stop here, looking at my elbow in both sides with this idea. From here, I will grab the wrist and I will pass my head downside the humerus area, downside the arm here, with the idea to hear for breaking here. It's a very strong and powerful control. From here, my hand passes beneath the leg here, close to the knee. I will put the palm on the ground, grab with both hands, and from here go to the ground. After here, we gain control here on one of the legs, and the other will be making this control to the knee. From here I will pass aside and I will this here to wrap here the neck and pressing with the idea, the main idea, to break here the neck. From here I will put at the side, move around to have this control, and a variation proposed, this is the end here, because we have the control. A variation proposed by Motoshima Sensei was the following: to step on here on the armpit and have this control on the right arm, that is the other one that we haven't broken. The other one was broken on the beginning on the technique, and now we have this control, avoiding him to take a tanto or any other weapon at he who were on the lobby on the belt. Then for some, please try to do it with me, and I will try to do it. From here, I will strike right, protecting with the elbows, avoiding me to strike here. Please, from here, passing. I have the control first to break. Now, grab, put the palm, take it down, right, move, right, from here, this, remember that I have this arm here broken, please continue, he has the control on the knee here, pass to the side, both controls on this knee that it's straight, and this one that it's bended, have this control. If I try here to strike, he's covering with this any kind of attack that I could handle with his hand. Press here, it is avoiding me to try to handle something or attack. And from here, control, running this arm right now, step on the armpit and control. This is the first sequence to explain. Right now we will follow the techniques with own attacks of Tanto. The first one, he will try to grab here and stop in this with this line, with this direction. From here what we will do is to protect. It's this, we have the Tanto, the blade. This is very dangerous. Then from here we will here bend, having control, look at my knee, having this control, passing, and from here we will pass to that point, careful with the blade and having this control. This will take out the blade. From here we get free of the blade, and from here we have the conditions to do the following. This passes to the ground, I'm having the control with my leg. From here I could go over the neck and break the cervical, or having control of the cervical. After this is performed, I could take the other wrist, and my hand goes, my left hand goes on the lapel here to perform the choke. Right now, put on side position, and from here, choke him until he falls completely. Then please, I will take the Tanto here, knife. From here, in a very surprising movement, what I will do is hand one, strike. He defends against this. The defense is very important here. Pass to my neck, turn him around. Beware, it's important to take here this, release my Tanto, make me this pass to the ground, have control, break my knee, my neck, sorry, from here, cross, grab, and put on the side to choke. This is a second of the classical sequences studies on this method. The third one, he will try to stab me on the kidney area. Then, when he take out, draw the Tanto, please, here, he will, here, and of course, from this position, he will try, remember that the attack is trying to stab on my kidneys, and from here what I will do is to stop, and he will try to go out. We need to handle here to have control, and I will move, I will switch my position here in order to explain better what happens here. Remember that in this case we will start facing to this wall to gain this position. Then it doesn't matter. From here what I will do is he could try to start again. Then to avoid the tsuki, I have my elbow to strike here, and I have this control. Remember that he will remain handling the tanto. Then from here, what we will need to do is this goes to the ground. It's very important to have this control here, and this will put the forearm over here. From here, knee over, having restrained both, we could release the tanto here, taking control on the eyes, on this, and we have this strong control, strong pressure. Remember something, we have on this sequence, we don't want to make a submission. What we want is to defend a real attack, and we need to be very strong on the pressure. Please continue. Right now, I will attack Sensei Tola, free here. I will do first one, I will go up, strike and go, come, place both hands, continue please, from here to the ground, pressure, knee. I have here, he's not pressing on my eyes, but having control on my neck and head. Okay, very well. Take right now the tanto. Okay, we'll continue on the next video with more sequence. Okay, going out of the kogi, remember that this is a dangerous visit. When the shogunin is having control on the lord space, in order to guarantee a perimeter of safety, in this case, right now we return to the shogunin study that try in this case also to attack the shogunin by a betrayal. Right now he will try to choke here. It's a very common choke trying, and usually what the goal that he will try to achieve is to take me backwards in order to have control, because if I go here it will be very difficult for me to defend. Then the idea here, we will move a little more forward, please. I have control, and I will do something very interesting here. It's the pressure with my head here to open here. From that side, I will cross that hand directly over myself. We have this control. From here we will break. I have right now, we could have this or this. Both are right. But it's very important that this wrist goes and have control between here on my legs. From here we could move to the ground, and having this, we have this control. Go forward. Have this control. This pressure is very, very painful. And remember, we don't want to make a submission. We want to break, because we are dealing with a traitor, and it's important to react in that way. Please, sensation. Try to perform it. When I try to have the choke and go into the side. Have control, make the pressure here, cross, this is painful for me, break it, break here, pass it, and right now, right, from here, remember this, okay, making face down to the ground, and this pressure breaks my elbow, continue to break it, but this, it's impossible to react. I have my scapular area control all my shoulders, and I have this in a very, very difficult way to react. Okay, the next thing that we will do is to he will try on this sequence to wrap my shoulder here on the back. sorry, at the aside. This is very important to have this and this to control and having this powerful movement. From here, this will break here. It's important we could change because from here it goes to the ground and gain control on this elbow here. This is very painful. We will try, it would be, if he is very well prepared, it's difficult to break here, but we could move over and trying to break here with the dynamics, it would be easier, the motion. From here, pass, and now we could have this strong, control that also could break here. It's very powerful movement. Right now, from here, we could pass here to the ground, making him to fade down to the ground, having this control. Of course, we will step on, look around with the idea of maybe trying to draw any of our weapons that we are having right now. Let's say this side. A very surprising movement. I have this control. He keeps the control, the forearm press on my face. From here I am controlled. He needs to do in that way. No, this is not the way. You have to with your okay. Right now, after this, you with this control on this and pass to the other hand. The other hand. Take control here. No, you are right. Okay, continue, pass this, control, and you, that's right, here. Now, and inside the armpit, right, perfect. From here, very, step on under control. On this position, he could try to choke. He could try to break my neck, my cervical spine, and here have control pressure, maybe with the head to the ground, etc. Remember that we will be dealing on tatami. Then the pressure don't are the same as if we did this pressure on a concrete or any solid ground. The next one, it will be on the following idea. He will try to grab, to hug me on the trunk, trying to make me fall to the side. Then, please, he will try here. My idea is to fall with him, but trying to go over himself. Of course, we could try to move wherever, and many people understand as a way to make the lock on the elbow. But these souvenirs are more clever. What we will do is to bend and having this control. Can you see? We have bended the elbow here, and what we will do is to move a little. We wait on. On the scapula, we wait on the back here, avoiding him to react because he will try to go up, draw the tantrum and whatever. But I have the weight here. With this strong control, what I will do is a rotation that will affect to the shoulder. This one. This is very painful, very powerful movement because we have the control of all our body. Waiting and pressuring on the shoulder. It's very painful. And on this technique, I will try to make a yoko do osae, morote do osae. When I hug and I press, he falls here and take profit on my motion, on my inertia to go to no, you don't need to chance, you have to, or not to this side, but to this side, remember?
Right
here, but it's not well. You have to gain control here to make the rotation on this.
Okay. Okay. Pressure weight on my on major weight. That's right.
But you have to cross your arms on this position. Then, but your right hand takes on the wrist and the other hand around.
That's right. That's right. Now go make the rotation.
It's very, very painful and very hard to react in this circuit. The last technique for today is the following one. Right now, he will try to hug me on the backside. Then it's an ushiro do sai. He will push me here, making me the control to the ground. We react and from here take control here on the heel and on the and on the ankle. From here we could press in order to make him fall to the ground. Take a look what we have here. We have here to break if we want to have control on the elbow here. We could, and from here we have this control, make him to put aside after this. We have both hands, we could unite here to have this control. After this, we move here. We gain a position that makes me to be capable to react in any kind of situation. And from here, moving to one side and breaking to the other. Then we will break the knee. One more time. Moving to one side, making to stress the knee joint. And from here, break to the other side and having control on what is happening around. We could step on, it's very painful. Having this strong control to react, growing in strength in order to defend the Lord, that is our main goal on this circumstance. And the last one, please, I will grab and I will move forward in order to trying to put himself face down to the ground. Then one from here, have control on the ankle, pull me to the ground. Okay, remember it's interesting if you have this control to break. Right now I could kick, and it's very important that you have control downside my knee back here in order to avoid. My following movement on this side, it will be this is release. Then I will try to handle a tanto in order to try, but in this position it's impossible for me to reach him. Then from here, he has the control, okay? He needs to be very well controlled on the knee. It's the key here. When he moves one, and breaks the knee here. And he could step on. It's important that this is on Suwari again, right? On this, it's pulling on this side. In order to avoid to be very slow on reactions when any other could be attacking at the same time.
Very well.
As you have seen, we have covered several sequences, several ideas, or the basic ideas of this morning, that the main goal here is that you understand better what are these sequences. Thank you very much. And congratulations to Sensei Tola for the great work he is performing there in Zamora.